Okay, so we got the specs out of the way, and now we want to go into the software. Now, this is running, I just got the HTC, give me one second, excuse me, I got the 4.3 update. Settings, go ahead and take a look at the software. So this is running HTC Sense 5.0, and it is running Android 4.3. Now, right off the bat, I would say I'm really happy at the fact that HTC is actually doing a little bit better at software updates. It's real nice. I believe this came out with 4.21 when it first released, but now today, as of today, it has 4.3 on it. Now, since 5.0. My last HTC phone was the HTC Thunderbolt when I was on Verizon. I love the HTC Sense. I'll say that off the bat. I like it, but they have to keep updating it and they have to keep innovating and making it a better skin. In my opinion, I think TouchWiz is a little bit better or non-intrusive versus the HTC Sense. But when I used the HTC Sense inside of or on this phone, it was excellent. I mean, I didn't have any problems with it. Personally, I don't prefer it. I wouldn't necessarily go after this phone because of Sense, but I don't want you guys to think that should deter you from buying the phone if you're okay with Sense. I mean, I would say, you know, take a look at it. I would say the biggest thing that I liked about Sense was Blink Feed. Now, Blink Feed, the only app that I could find in the market that came close to Blink Feed was Flipboard. But the reason why Blink Feed like is so much better than Flipboard is that it's actually integrated into the actual browser. Excuse me, not browser, the actual launcher. So if you go ahead and pinch, you can see it has the different screens and the actual home screens. And Blink Feed has its own home screen to itself. And I really like that because of the fact that everything is here. I mean, I unlock my phone, bring it up, and it's like, you know, instead of me going to each one of my apps and, you know, digging for the information as they try to, the word that they use in the advertisements, I can just flip over and see everything right here. And it's nice. I mean, it's not in the way. It's not, you know, it doesn't lag. I would say that. It's really cool. I mean, personally, like I said, I would keep it. You can easily reset it. Like, it acts like it's an actual app, but you're not going into it. So it's easily accessible. Whereas over here on the side, I actually have Flipboard running. I have to click this button for it to refresh. I can't, you know, move this up and down or anything like that to go to the next story. This actually just feels more natural. I have Facebook, Instagram, my different websites that I go to, like my RSS feeds, all that stuff pulls into this one program and I can see everything. I mean, that's cool. And if I have the option to say, you know what, I only want to see Instagram, I only want to see Google Plus, whatever it is, you can click on the individual apps and go in it that way if you want to dig deeper. But this kind of just shows you everything on this hour. And it's nice. I mean, everything I take from this phone software-wise, Blink Feed has been the most, the top one feature that I love about HTC One. The second feature I would say is the camera. I really love, like, and I would say, unfortunately, this is the only thing that hopefully changes with KitKat that I didn't like about stock Android on the Nexus 4, is that I do not have as much options to manipulate the photos within the camera. Right off the bat, right here, you can see this little square right here. It gives you the option, if it'll let me click it. Oh, I guess basically you can't use Zoe on it. All right. So it gives me the option to, you know, apply a filter on the fly, which, granted, yes, you can get an app that automatically does this. I'm not saying that, you know, this is like game breaking, like, oh yeah, this is the best thing ever. You can get another app, but I like that this is built in. I don't have to have another app that does this. It's built in. I like the Zoe feature, which you click it and you can take a video. Let me see if I put one up. I actually had some pictures on here. And when you click on it, it actually plays a video. You can see it has a sound. You can actually go through it and pick through the different like frames. You can highlight a frame, keep it, save it for later, which is cool. I like that because, you know, as a family man, you know, I have my children, and it would be nice to take a video and be able to pick through the frames. But like I said, you know, that app, you know, I'm going to say this, if you guys know an app like that on the Market Store, let me know, because I actually want to do a review on that. But I like that this comes with the phone. And I think that's one of the things that I like about Google, is that we have so many choices and everything in the ecosystem, that it's not just one thing. If I don't like this, I can go with another phone. And then even still, if you, like with me, if you want to stay with the Nexus line, there's apps in the store that give you the functionality, which is real nice and it's cool. So going, moving on, we the other feature that I like, let me unlock it. The other feature that I like is the front speaker. So let's go ahead and... Where is my Google Music? Let's go ahead and play some music. I will say I kind of did not like the app drawer. It was kind of confusing at first. It was kind of confusing at first. I could have done without that. I'm not even going to go into it. I just could have really, really done without that. And for some reason, I don't have my Google Music on here. Oh, yeah, they put it in media. That's where it's at. Play music. And let's go ahead and play something. So, actually, let's see how the bass sounds on this thing. So, we're going to play some dubstep. Where's my bass cannon? Right here. So, let's go ahead and play this. See how well this sounds. So, it's okay. Bass is not all that there. I'm pretty sure it probably sound better on the 3.5mm. But let's go ahead and play something that doesn't, that's not all super loud. Let's play some Drake. No? Didn't know his intro was that long. So, it's nice. I mean, with it being covered up, it's still pretty loud. Alright, so, bam, that was the speakers. They're pretty nice. I mean, I think they market this more towards watching a video than they do actually listening to loud music. But even still, if I was somewhere, I've tried using this, you know, if I'm washing dishes, turn the music on, and it's pretty loud. It's nice. I like that it's in the front. It's coming towards you. It's a nice sound. I enjoy the speakers being there. It does double for a microphone and the earphone for when you're calling. So calling quality is excellent. I mean, the best I've ever heard. And that's about it. I mean, as far as the software, you know, we got the Sense overlay. There's different options and stuff like that, which is always cool. I mean, I don't use any of the other stuff that's on here. I mean, the gallery is pretty cool. Have this, my dirty gadgets. But you can see it's a beautiful camera. I love it. It's a nice phone. It's pretty banging. I mean, personally, I would definitely recommend getting this phone. I will have a final review soon. Thanks for watching, you guys. Those are the three major things that I liked about HTC One, and I hope you guys liked it. If you got any other questions about the phone and my experience, shoot me a comment in the comments down at the bottom. All right, see ya. Peace.